starting to previously I worked somewhere in that starting with my technical support, desktop support, system admin, and the network area. And after that, I get an opportunity in the MNC roles of CMS levels. In that, I can get a role of network support, like formatting the machines and networking, routing and switching, mostly on routing and switching. And after that, whenever I have a time of specific time to train the freshers from whoever joined from the end of the team. Mm-hmm. So like CCNA, network services, networking, mm-hmm. and Windows, Linux, and these topics has to be completed by regularly or whatever it may be. That's depending on the requirement, mm-hmm. The project requirements, so that we can able to explain the entire thing of the training part.
Okay. So, I am also working from like a couple of years as a storage admin here in the United States. So, we manage the EMC NetApp, and you know, we have Cisco 9K switches. So, I mean, I'm pretty much familiar with the 9K into, and I do the deployment and configuration. I do the troubleshooting. I mean, I know the switches very well. So, I mean, I'm not on the networking part, but it's only on the fiber channel that I'm dealing. So, now it's all going towards the software defined storage. So, I mean, I thought, like, why not I get trained in the network, network field, and clear CCNA, and you know, in the long term I can go for CCNP. So that's the reason, like, I mean, I know the basics, but I'm not a networking person.
Okay. That means you configure 9K switches, means what? That is the Cisco switches only, right?
Yes, Cisco 9710 switches. Like I deployed 18 switches, which are connected to the VMAXs EMC SRDF. I did the SRDF metro configuration on the switches.
Okay, means that is related to fiber or
that is related to fiber channel.
Okay. Now means what you are expecting, means in the networking part, what you are expecting, and what the basics you want from the basics. Or directly we enter into the CCNA routing and switching.
It would be very nice if we have a quick session of basics, not too long, but at least like a couple of days. I would like to fresh up all my basics and then switch into the switches and routers.
Okay, you know the switches configurations, that router configurations.
Router I did not deal with, but switches, yes, I did. I dealt with Cisco and Brocade switches.
So creating of VLANs and
completely right from the switch when it is delivered onto the data center to getting it live. That is the work I do here.
Okay, basics means that's once again I will show what exactly giving to the routing and switching modules from the overview. That's after that we will start with the demo.
Okay, give me 1 minute. I'll grab a pen and a paper. I'll just make a note of a few things when you go through.
Sure.
Okay. Hello. Please continue.
Yes, yes. Fine. As the schedule of network product case and the networking part, mostly of the CCNA, before that, we're going to the basics. That basics means so fundamentals part means see the here the session serial number one given fundamentals part means OSI layers. The OSI layers are very important. You know awareness on OSI layers?
No, I don't know why I said layers.
So that is okay. That is important of OSI layers. What exactly layer seven layers are there and how it will be work and how it will be familiar and what are the functionalities of OSI layers and what are the uses of OSI layers. Which layer and which specification it will be working, that it will be put in the OSI layers and TCP/IP suite. And
Okay.
the network addressing schema, this is one of the key part of CCNA, not only CCNA in the networking entire part. This part will be covered in the IP addressing, IP addressing subnet. You know creating how to assign IP address on the machine?
I'm familiar with the assigning IP address.
That's IP address and subnetting part is very, very important. Means that's if the subnetting part is good, then we can able to have a good familiar with the upcoming networks of MPLS or BGP networks or protocols, whatever the protocols will be there, that it will be, have to be segregated. What a subnetting means nothing. This have to be which in a large network we can able to break up into the small networks to providing the network to the resources. So that is a part of in the IP address schema.
So it is like a private VLAN, right? I mean, if you want to segregate the IPs, like it's like a private VLAN.
Similarly, that but this is not a private VLAN, but whatever you said, the private VLAN, like the private VLAN, we have to segregate the network into large network into smaller network by providing the network interfaces. So that is the part that two is the very, very basics. This we need to be covered. And coming to the next basics of switching, you know already awareness of switching. But anyhow, we can able to give a short whatever the review of the switching of concept operation of a switch and the starting with the switch internal components of a switch booting process types of switches and basic introduction CLI logging banner tips. These also you know I hope that configuration
We set up the banner and
interface descriptions
we
passwords.
port descriptions and password we use, we create the roles, we create the passwords.
Okay, that's a D. And coming to the DTP, DTP modes of access trunk, dynamic desirable, dynamic auto. So this will be comes of the VLAN part. Okay, and the mostly switching VLANs and necessity of virtual LANs and types of VLANs and this VLAN part and VTP part. Mostly there is DTP, VLAN, VTP, it will be covered by mostly in the switching part. And next, the STP is the looping spanning tree protocol. Did you work on STP?
No, we have a core edge.
Okay, storage. Okay.
So this is like a spine leaf, spine. Are you talking about the spine leaf or what is this? Spining
Not
tree?
finally, that's a spanning tree. Yes, spanning tree
Okay,
protocol
no.
means looping free topology of redundancy to checking with the if any
No.
in between the errors will be come here.
No, I don't know about this.
Yes, sir, that's what CCNA. That's different. That's one is and securing a switch of configuration port security. And the backup and restore of running config and startup config, that's we will we know of iOS. And next, after completing with this, then we come up with the routing. So starting with the routing, the whatever we have to be learn the switching, same thing we the same similarly both are the same, but initially some internal changes will be there because the switch is processing on the frames like MAC address with the support of MAC address, but the router is working on the packets like source to destination to be sending the network information in between the protocols. And it's the same, whatever the same configuration is same, but little bit some more internal changes will be there to compare to the switch, the familiar with the routing part. IP routing, we have the this is also basic one, and what we covered is static routing, dynamic routing, and LSR. I think this is we need to be more deep for understanding because you are not awareness on router, right? So this.
I don't have
Once
the
we
router.
enter the practical part, we can able to do it. That's not an issue. Okay.
So, Sorry to interrupt you.
Yeah, fine.
I apologize. So, how are we doing the practicals? Like, would you give me access to? I mean, do you have any lab switches or like how is it the practicals?
No, practical that you know awareness on Cisco packet tracer.
Yes.
Yeah, Cisco packet tracer. If you're familiar with the Cisco packet tracer, we can go with the Cisco packet tracer, or we can connect with the GNS3. GNS3 awareness.
No, I don't know GNS3 awareness.
Okay, fine. The GNS3 is the one of the most advanced whatever the real time visualizations things to be worked on that. But I worked on that. So that is very means initially it's difficult because in the familiar with the packet, you worked on packet tracer.
No, I didn't work because we have a engineering lab here. I mean, I have all the switches, like whatever is the switch I have access. I mean, I cannot share my screen, but I have access to all the switches. Whatever I do here, I'll go and practice it in my lab also, in my
Okay, fine.
office.
Yeah, okay, fine. See here, I will show the Cisco packet tracer. This is one of the
Okay.
tool. It will take roughly 200, the latest version 202 MB. So
Mm-hmm.
here, latest version 7.1. 7.1 I downloaded.
Okay.
So this one is a
Seven.
very comfort. Whatever we have to be learned, every CCNA training or whatever any student or associates has to be coming up with this only, because it's look like a visualization. It's look like real time, but it is not a real switches. But
Okay.
similarly, whatever the real switches are working here also, it will be worked on entirely part of routing. And
Okay.
here routers are there, means what type of routers are to be worked, series of routers, all the latest routers also to be placed on that in
Okay.
network. And the
Okay.
switches 2960 and what IEEE, not a fiber switches also will be there, but this is the generic switches. And some is multi-layer switches and
Okay.
some part of 2950. Yes, I
Okay,
think you are.
I mean, I don't need 9,000 switches because we already have there. I would like to see other switches as well, so should
Yes.
be good.
Yes. Okay. And it's wireless between in the network, we have to be configured the wireless and cell tower and the CO server. So these equipments also we will use beside that depending on the requirement. Means after the troubleshooting side, means the troubleshooting means once we completed the CCNA routing and switching part, then we can able to troubleshoot some my laptop. I'm not getting laptop to Wi-Fi, but the system whatever I another laptop Wi-Fi is coming. So like that
Okay.
we can able to troubleshoot like internally login with the Wi-Fi router, and a lot of the troubleshooting things we can. And most
Okay.
advanced latestly the security field, security Cisco ASA 5505 firewall. So this is the very uninterrupted network. We need to be enter the network to configure the giving the access of outside network to the inside network. So this only the Cisco ASA will be worked, and the
Okay.
cloud network, cloud generic DSL modem. We can depending on the requirement only these all the tools we can able to use. So in
Okay.
here we can able to learn entire part of CCNA routing and switching, troubleshooting everything. Once we brief,
Okay.
then we understood of all the topics.
Okay, perfect. So, how many days would it take to complete the training?
Yeah, that means that only that is you depending on your requirement, because myself present there is no at the blocked by calendar. It's a
Okay.
time spot in the morning time, mostly in the 7 to in this between time. Okay, I'm comfort. But if you
Okay, I
want,
mean, in this month of December, like I'm little free. If at all you want to do it in this month, I am completely fine with that. Let's do it this month.
okay,
Okay.
this month, right? Fine. And so what timings? That's what a familiar timings for you. That's.
So what time works for you? Like actually, I am on vacation this month, so I'm in Dallas. So I am in EST, sorry, CST.
Okay.
This time is good for you?
Yes.
So if this time is good, like, I mean, let's do it in this time.
Yeah, 7 to specific time, 7 to 9 or 7 to 10. What? How many hours daily you need?
Like I Are you comfortable for 7 to 8:30 or 9?
Yeah, fine. 7 to 8:30, fine.
7 to 8:30 is fine. Okay. I mean, I don't want to make it too long because once you go through everything, I'll take some time. I will try to get to the speed. I mean, I don't want to just go through and forget everything after 1 month. So I'll prepare
No.
some notes and prepare it for a real time use of mine.
Yes, definitely. So definitely, I will provide all the see whatever I shown here means not demo means I will take a class. But before you understand the overview, what I need to tell, right? So that's why I open this sheet for understanding, and another one I will give the clarity of what exactly the certificate preparation means. What if you are preparing for certification? So I will also train accordingly the certification part. If you want to write a CCNA latest 200 125, right? CCNA version 3. Now is latest version 3 is going on. So if you want to be right, that's a certification in that part also. VPNs also added, so that I will add. So this is the course catalog. I can come up with all these parts of basics. From basics, starting basics, we will go to. So the preparation means you don't be forget it after 1 month, and if you're not practice. So I will prepare accordingly certification part. So you must be assured that you will be, once you prepared here, you will be able to crack the certification.
Yeah, sure. Like, once I complete the training, I will put like 2 weeks of time and book a CCNA training. I will like because already I have. I don't say I'm completely 100% perfect with the switching and routing, but I mean, we recently started working on the switches, so it's just been like 1 year. So I just want to learn from the very basic thing. In that way, I have a better understanding of things
Yeah,
anyway.
that's why, that is only basic. Starting basics means what is network, okay, what is cable and what type of cables are there, and what is the differences between switch and router, and how we configure the IP address, and what is IP address, and how IP address will be designed, and how the split into IP address, and what is the gateway, what is the subnet mask, everything. I will start with the whatever I given the schedule, everything I will start from the basics. Then only you can able to get the routing and switching. If the basic is not good, again in the routing part and switching part, again we require the subnet and some more and the things, so that it will be difficult to understand. So that's why starting with the basics of binary subnetting, then we can able to understand a clearly concept.
Okay, sure. Thank you. I like the demo and we'll start the course.
Sure.
Srinivas, are you on the call? Is Srinivas?
Hey, hey.